Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Let me show you how to create buttons on your iPhone home screen to go directly to specific settings. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 1,000 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So on your iPhone, sometimes settings that you often want to get to are buried deep down and you have to remember where they are and then take several steps to get there. For instance, say you want to switch on and off silence unknown callers. You could go into settings, then you have to scroll all the way down and find phone, and then you have to go to silence unknown callers, go inside there, and there's the switch to turn it on or off. Be great if there was a way to just tap a button here and go directly to that setting. Well, you can do that using the Shortcuts app, but you need to know some hidden codes in order to do so. So let's go into Shortcuts, and then I'm going to create a new shortcut like that. And I'm going to add action. Now the action I'm going to add is kind of counterintuitive. I'm going to go to Apps, and then I'm going to go down to Safari, and then in Safari, I'm going to Open URLs. So what does opening a URL in Safari have to do with getting to a specific screen in the Settings app? Well, it turns out that if you put just the right URL in there, it will actually do exactly that. So you have to start these special URLs with prefs, P-R-E-F-S. And then you need to use a colon and then root and then equals. Now here you will put the name of the preferences section, but it's not the name that appears in the Settings app. It's a specific name inside the code. So you have to know what the actual code name is for that. So you can either guess or you can look it up in a list, and I'll show you a list later. For instance, to get to the Bluetooth settings, it's simply just Bluetooth. So capital B, just like that. So prefs colon root equals Bluetooth. Done. Now let's assign this shortcut a name. So in here, I'll just call it Settings Direct. As an example, you might want to call it Bluetooth Settings. And you could set the icon and color here as well. And you could see here, you can even use Hey Siri to activate this. I'm going to click here to add to the home screen. So I'm going to click Add to Home Screen. And you can see it's called Settings Direct and it's got that icon. We'll add it. Now you can see I've added it to my home screen. Now, if I just tap this, it goes directly to Bluetooth settings. Now what about digging deeper into settings? Let's go in here and edit this. Instead of going to Bluetooth, let's go to General. And that's just General as you would expect. And then you need to use the ampersand and then the word Path to dig deeper into General settings. Put equals, and then we need to know the actual code name for this subsection. So as an example, let's go to the software update screen. So you have a quick way to check for software updates. The code name for that is in all caps, software_update_link. So just like that. Now we'll click done and we'll return to the home screen. And now when we use that shortcut, it goes directly to software update. Sometimes you need to go down even more levels than this. So one path is keyboard with a capital K, and then slash, and then down a level even deeper than that. So this will take us into General, into Keyboard, and into the User Dictionary subsection, which is also known as Text Replacements. So if you often go here to edit your text replacements, add new ones, now you have a shortcut to do it right there on the home screen. And how about the Battery Health screen? That's a subscreen of the regular battery screen in Settings. So this is the path to get there. So now we can go directly there. And remember the silence call screen I talked about earlier? Well, here's the path to get there. It's in the phone settings in the path silence_calls. So now we can get there with just one tap and turn it on or off. Now in the Settings app, there are a lot of settings for specific apps. All the different apps that you may have installed. It'd be great to be able to go directly to one of those. And you can. But it's a little tricky because the actual path to these uses the identifier for the app, which is hidden from us. So it's not just the name of the app. It's the actual what's called bundle ID for that app. So let me show you how to find that. It's a little tricky. It takes a bunch of steps. But you can get it. Once you have that bundle ID, setting up the shortcut is the same. So go in your browser. I'm going to do it on the Mac here. And search for the name of the app and maybe put App Store and Apple after it and then do a search. And you should come up with a link for apps.apple.com. Go to that and then look for the number after the letters ID. So in this case, this is the app number in the App Store. We're going to copy that. Then we're going to go to the URL itunes.apple.com/lookup?id=, and that number. So go there. And it's going to want to download a file. So we'll allow downloads. Then we're going to go to the downloads folder and you'll find it there. It's just a little text file, in this case 1.txt. I'm going to open that up and text edit. And then I'm going to do Command F to find and search for bundle ID and return. And we'll see here bundle ID, and then after that is the actual bundle ID. So it's usually com dot and the company name dot the app name. But in this case, the company name's abbreviated and it gets the app name, has a capital T and then the number 2 after it. So it's not easy to just guess it. You have to go through these steps. And this is what we want to use in the Shortcuts app. Just put it after prefs colon root equals and paste exactly that bundle ID. And it should look like that. So now when we go to the home screen and use the shortcut, it goes directly to the settings for that app. Now what if we wanted to go to the notifications settings for that app? That's similar. We still need that bundle ID. But instead, we're going to use root equals notifications underscore ID and then the path to be that bundle ID for the app. So now we have a quick way to get to the notification setting for that app. So where to find all of the hidden codes so you can create these shortcuts? Well, there are lots of places online. One is this GitHub repository here. Just go to this URL and then look down further for the full list and then go there and then you'll find a huge list of them. They change all the time though with new updates, especially the major updates. So not all these are guaranteed to work right away, but if you do more searches, you may be able to come up with the updated value for each one. But as you can see, just about every settings section and subsection is accounted for here. Just note when you enter these, if you mistype something or something has changed, then it's not going to go anywhere. It'll just open the settings app and it won't go to that specific section. You're not going to get an error message or anything. So make sure you type everything exactly. When in doubt, make sure the case is the same, uppercase or capital, and everything is spelled exactly as it should be. So I hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.